The next talk is about related tweak statistical saturation cryptanalysis and its application to QARMA. And the authors are Muzhou Li, Gai Hu, and Meiqin Wang. And Muzhou is going to give the talk.
Good morning, everyone. Thanks for the introduction. I'm honored to have the chance to present my paper on this special occasion. The title of my paper is Related Tweak, Statistical Saturation Cryptanalysis and its Application on QARMA. This paper is a joint work with Kai Hu and my supervisor, Meiqin Wang. Previous statistical saturation attacks proposed by Collard and Standard are all implemented under single key setting, and there is no public attack model under related key or related tweak setting. In our paper, we proposed a new cryptanalytic method, which is called related key or related tweak statistical saturation attack. And we have proved that distinguishers used in this new method are conditional equivalent with those utilized in the key or tweak difference invariant bias technique. Hereafter, we will call the key or tweak difference invariant bias technique as KDIB or TTIB technique for short. And then an automatic searching algorithm for KDIB or TTIB distinguishers is also proposed. At last, we mounted a related tweak, statistical saturation, and TTIB attacks on reduced round QARMA. At first, let me briefly recall the KDIB technique in KRT 19 ciphers proposed by Bogdanov et al. The definition of KRT 19 block ciphers was proposed by German and Wyman in the AS book. As we can see, each round key KI is XORed into the state at the end of round I, and a round key zero is also XORed into the state before the first round. We use key to denote this column vector, where each round key I is derived from the mask key capper. Epsilon theta I minus 1 theta I denotes the bias around I, and the bias of the linear trio theta on the capper is epsilon theta capper, which can be denoted as this equation. And then the bias of linear hole gamma lambda on the capper is epsilon capper, which can be denoted as this. From this equation, we have the following conclusion. If this equation holds for all linear trio theta with epsilon theta not equal to zero in the linear hull, then biases under these two keys are equal to each other, and this is called KDIB condition in our paper. With this KDIB condition, we can give the definition of a KDIB distinguisher. A KDIB distinguisher contains many linear hulls as well as a fixed key difference data. But it can be called as a KDIB distinguisher only when there exists a pair of keys, such that their difference is delta, and they satisfy the KDIB condition for each linear hull. For tweak alternative ciphers, we can give a similar attack method, which is called TDIB attack in our paper. TDIB is similar with KDIB, since tweak has the same effect on the bias of linear hole with key for tweak alternating ciphers. Therefore, we have the following conclusion that if TDIB condition holds, these two bases are equal to each other. Now, let me introduce our new proposed method, related tweak statistical saturation cryptanalysis. Assume the block size of the target cipher is n. In the statistical saturation cryptanalysis, one fixes a part of plaintext bits, which means these R bits are fixed, and then he or she takes all possible values for the other S bits. After obtaining the cipher texts, he or she considers the distribution of a part of the cipher text value, which means he or she will check the value distribution of these T bits. In our new proposed method, we also fixes a part of a plain text base and checks all possible values for the other plain text base. But we encrypt this plain text under related key or related trick pairs. After obtaining these two sets of cipher texts, we compare value distributions of these two parts. In this method, the adversary can encrypt these plain text under different key or trick pairs as long as they have same difference data. Besides, we also found that a related key or related trick statistical saturation distinguishers are conditional equivalent with KDIB or TDIB distinguishers. Since we will apply this method on the trickable block cipher QARMA, we will only introduce the conditional equivalence between related trick statistical saturation distinguisher and TDIB distinguisher. For the other conditional equivalent property, we will omit it since it has nothing different with this one. Before giving the conditional equivalence property, we make a decomposition of the target cipher. Denote the target cipher with n-bit block and k-bit trick as h, and then we split the input into two parts, x, y. The r-bit x is the part fixed in our check, and the s-bit y is the part taking all possible values. The output of h is also divided into two parts, h1, h2, and we only focus on the value distribution of h1. Besides, we also define a function ti, where ti is actually the function h1 when x equals to the constant value I. With this decomposition, we can give the following theorem. Let gamma lambda be the linear whole of h, with gamma separated into two parts. The first part is the r-bit gamma in, and the mask values on the other s-bits is zero. The output mask lambda is also divided into two parts. Lambda out is the t-bit value, and it cannot be zero. Under this condition, when given a fixed difference data, we have the following conclusion. If the bias is invariant under related trick pairs for all possible mask pairs gamma in, lambda out, then these two TI values will have same value distribution and vice versa. This means same bias implies same value distribution, and same value distribution implies same bias. Given an R1 round distinguisher, we can mount key recovery checks by adding R2 rounds after it. At first, we chose a set of plain text P where X is fixed to be I and Y takes all possible values. And then we can obtain these two sets of cipher texts by encrypting this plain text under these two tricks. And then we guess corresponding key bits to obtain these two TI values. If they have same value distribution, the guessed key bits are taken as red key bits, otherwise they will be discarded. The probability to reject red key is zero, and the probability to accept a wrong key fulfills this equation. This equation implies that the probability is sufficiently small. In practice, when finding a related trick or related key, a statistical saturation distinguisher directly is extremely hard, but a KDIB or TDIB distinguisher can be easily discovered. Hence, we can first find a KDIB or TDIB distinguisher, and then we convert it into related key or related trick statistical saturation distinguisher by following the way introduced in the conditional equivalent property. Now, let me introduce how to search for KDIB distinguishers with STP for KR19 ciphers. The other searching algorithm for TDIB distinguishers is similar with this one, thus we omit it. STP is a decision procedure to confirm whether there is a solution to a set of equations. So our job here is to build some equations. From previous KDIB attacks, distinguishers were derived at word level for linear masks and bit level for key difference. Hence, in our searching algorithm, we focus on word level mask propagation property in the round function and bit level difference propagation properties for the key schedule. In practice, when aiming at finding R-round KDIB distinguishers, we always have to describe mask propagation properties from two sets, and their meeting point should have same active pattern. Our whole algorithm can be divided into four parts. The first part describes the word-level mask propagation properties. For the substitution operation, the active state of output mask set out equals to the active state of input mask set in. For the XOR operation, denotes active states of these two input masks as set in 1 and set in 2 respectively, and the corresponding active states of output mask set out equals to set in 1 equals to set in 2. When describing word-level mask propagation property of three-branch operation, we always have to decide mask active state of one of these three branches according to mask active states of the other two branches. Assume that we have known mask active states of these two branches, denoted as theta 1 and theta 2 respectively. Then the mask active state of the other branch, theta 3, will equal to 1 if theta 1 equals to 1 or theta 2 equals to 1. The theta variables being 1 means that this word is potentially active or definitely active. The linear layer can often be represented as a matrix multiplication to specify its word-level mask propagation property. We have to introduce the definition of deterministic pattern. Let the column vector m in, m out respectively denote the column-wise mask active states of input and output of m. Then the pair m in, m out is called to be a deterministic pattern if m out is unique given m in. And we use set g to record these deterministic patterns. With this set G, we have the following conclusion. If the column-wise active state of input set in belongs to this set G, then the column-wise active state of output mask set out will equal to the corresponding M out. Otherwise, all words of the output will be potentially active, which means theta out equals to this equation, this vector. The first part is used to depict bit-level difference propagation properties. For the substitution operation, let DDT represent its differential distribution table, and dot in, dot out respectively denote the input and output differences. If the corresponding propagation probability is P, then we have this equation, and P cannot be zero. For the XOR operation, the output difference dot out equals to the XOR value of these two input differences. For the three-branch operation, these three differences will equal to each other. Part 3 describes the KDIB condition. Given an R-round linear hole, theta 0, theta r, and the difference on key, we have the following KDIB condition, which is this equation holds for all possible linear trios with epsilon theta not equal to 0 in this linear hole. Since theta variables are 1-bit values and the dot variables are specific differences, we have to rephrase this KDIB condition into word level, which means if this word is active, then the corresponding key difference should be zero. Otherwise, we will have no restriction on its difference. The last part, part four, describes some necessary restrictions. In order to exclude trivial solutions, we have to require that at least one round key difference is non-zero. Besides, equations describing the active state of input and output masks are also included in this part. For ciphers containing S-box in their key schedule, equations restricting the total propagation probability are included in this part. Combining all these four parts and the input and then input these equations into STP, we can obtain KDIB conditions. Now we will apply our new cryptanalytic method and our searching algorithm on QARMA. QARMA is a trickable block cipher, and this is its structure. It supports two kinds of block sizes, 64 and 128, denoted by QARMA 64 and QARMA 128. The key size is 2 times n, which is separated into two parts, W0, K0 with semilence, and the trick size is n bit. QARMA 64 has 16 rounds and QARMA 128 has 24 rounds. Utilizing our searching algorithm, we can obtain 7 different 8-round TDIB distinguishers for both versions, and this is one of them for QARMA 64. In this distinguisher, these two input masks should have same mask value as well as these two output masks. Since we will only add several rounds after the distinguisher when mounting related tweak statistical saturation checks, the first round of the distinguisher should be a reduced round. Hence, these two input masks can take all possible values, but these two output masks should have same value. Since the output mask cannot take all possible values, we have to introduce the following theorem to obtain invariant value distribution property. Theorem 3 tells us that if the output mask satisfies the restriction that these two mask values should be the same, then we have the following conclusion. If we fix these two words into a fixed value I and take all possible values for y, then the XOR value of these two words will have same value distribution with the XOR value of these two words. Utilizing this 8-round related trick statistical saturation distinguishers, we can mount key recovery checks on 10-round QARMA 64, and this is our result. This check is the longest attack result considering out-whitening key. Besides, we also mounted TDIB attacks on 11-round QARMA 128. And this is also the best result considering out-whitening key in terms of numbers of rounds. My report is finished. Thanks for your attention.
Any question? If not, I have one. Did you try to apply to any other cipher, or is there any specific reason to apply to QARMA only?
We didn't apply this technique to other ciphers. I think there is no specific reason for to attack QARMA. I just read the document of QARMA and apply this method. Okay. Thank you.
Let's thank the speaker again.